Today is the first Sunday of Advent. It marks the beginning of the Christian year. It marks the beginning of the season when we prepare for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, the light of the world.
In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that the light was good. And God separated the light from darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day.
Who created the heavens and stretched them out, who spread out the earth and what comes from it, who gives breath to the people upon it and spirit to those who walk in it. I am the Lord. I have called you in righteousness. I have taken you by the hand and kept you. I have given you as a covenant to the people, a light to the nations, to open the eyes that are blind, to bring prisoners from the dungeon, from the prison, those who sit in darkness. I am the Lord, that is my name. My glory I give to no other, nor my praise to idols. See, the former things have come to pass, and new things I now declare. Before they spring forth, I tell you of them.
But now thus says the Lord, he who created you, O Jacob, he who formed you, O Israel, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I'll be with you, and through the rivers they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Saviour.
Heavenly Father,
you have created a universe of light. Forgive us when we return to darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the light of the world. Forgive us when we ignore your call, Christ. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Holy Spirit, you give us light in our hearts. Renew in us faith and love. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear then the word of grace. Your sins are forgiven. Thanks be to God.
Sing and rejoice, O daughter Zion, for lo, I will come and dwell in your midst, says the Lord. Many nations shall join themselves to the Lord on that day and shall be my people. And I will dwell in your midst. And you shall know that the Lord of hosts has sent me to you. The Lord will inherit Judah as his portion in the Holy Land, and will again choose Jerusalem. Be silent, all people, before the Lord, for he has roused himself from his holy dwelling.
The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult, divide and plunder. For a child has been born to us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onwards and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. Those who believe in him are not condemned, but those who do not believe are condemned already, because they have not believed in the name of the only Son of God. And this is the judgment, that the light has come into the world, and people love darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. For all who do evil hate the light and do not come to the light, so that their deeds may not be exposed. But those who do what is true come to the light, so that it may be clearly seen that their deeds have been done in God.
We believe in God, robed in splendor, veiled in mystery, ruler alike of darkness and light. We encounter God in Jesus Christ, who was tortured and put to death, but whose radiance could not be quenched, whose touch brings a blaze of color to a dull, drab world, reviving the weary, healing the wounded, dazzling the satisfied. We walk with God, guided by the light of God's loving Spirit, who enters the shadowed places of our hearts and leads us into truth and life. We wait for God and for the fulfillment of God's promises, for the time when the darkness will hold no fear and the light will no longer blind, but creation will be made whole once more and God's peace will reign forever. Amen.
Thank you. trusting in the words of our Lord Jesus Christ, I am the light of the world. We bring our prayers and petitions to our Heavenly Father. Almighty God and Father, we pray for peace in a world of broken promises, where violence, corruption, and famine blight innocent lives. Be a beacon of hope to those who despair, and a guiding light to all who work for peace and justice. O Lord our God, lighten our darkness. We pray for a world where religions are in conflict, where people are confused, skeptical, or hostile. Be a beacon of truth to all who seek knowledge, and a uniting light for all Christian people. O Lord our God, lighten our darkness. We pray for a world made for relationships, for families, friends, and the people we find difficult. Be a beacon of love for those who are lonely or hurt, and a forgiving light for those who live with bitter hearts. O Lord our God, lighten our darkness. We pray for ourselves with our joys, sorrows, and the pressures of daily life. As we prepare for your coming, let us make space for your light to shine in our lives. Enable us to become beacons of hope, truth, and love in your world. O Lord our God, lighten our darkness. As our Saviour taught us, in faith and trust we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
The more astute of you will have noticed that the choir didn't sing one or two things that were in there. We were trying to be green and not reprint unnecessarily, use paper unnecessarily. There is one other amendment, and that is that there will be no collection during the next hymn. There will, however, be a retiring collection if you would be so kind and gracious to give to the work of our church here. Your offerings will be gratefully received. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
world so much that he sent his only Son, give you grace to prepare for life eternal. Amen. May God the Son, who comes to us as Redeemer and Judge, reveal to you the path from darkness to light.
Amen.
May God, the Holy Spirit, by whose working the Virgin Mary conceived the Christ, help you to bear the fruits of holiness.
Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
As we await our coming Saviour, go in the peace of Christ.
Amen.